अकृतिम चापि भूतानि, अकृतिम चापि भूतानि, कथयिष्यन्ति इति व्यायम, कथाया शांति इति व्यायम, संभवस्य च कर्तिर, संभवस्य च कर्तिर, मरानर्द अर्तिर्चाते, मनानर्द अचिर्त्याचे. Besides, men will ever recount your ill fate, and for one who has been honored, ill fate is worse than death. If Arjun thinks that leaving the battlefield will make him famous and loved by saying all these lives and putting Duryodhana on throne, then Sri Krishna proves that this is his mistake, as people will recount his ill fame. The second part of this verse has become a saying in Sanskrit, Sambhari Nasya Na Kartir Marani Rishchayate, meaning that as soon as someone has reached a level of honor and then he gets ill fame, he will feel that it is better for earth to split open and he will fall in it rather than to live. It is a worse situation than death. Sri Krishna is telling Arjun this after taking into account his mentality. He is telling Arjun that people will talk about how he abandoned his Swadharma. Swadharma is an inbuilt process. There are so many strengths inside people. God has created us for a reason. This is what we must think about first. For what purpose have I been made? What is the reason for my birth? What is my potentiality? What strengths I have? How can I bring out strengths? If a person asks himself these questions, then he will always be successful. If a person does things that take him away from his strengths, then he will always be a failure. So the question in Sadharma is to ask, what are my strengths? Why God has created, why God has created me? What is the reason of my birth? What is my potentiality? Sri Krishna is saying here, as he will also go on to say in the 8th chapter, that if Arjun does not go into the battle, he will escape his nature. His nature is what? He is a Kshatriya, so that's his nature to fight. So he will escape his nature. And if he does not go, to the forest with a bow and arrow to kill animals and rabbits, Arjun will not be able to do without it, because he is a Kshatriya in his blood. If Arjun had to come to battle for the first time and said that he did what he did to Sri Krishna, then Sri Krishna would tell him, fine, let's go then. However, Arjun has fought many battles before and has had victory in many wars. So how could he behave like this? This will lead to ill fame. We must understand the meaning of what is inside us. In modern world, the biggest sadness is that everyone is misplaced. Everyone is not where they should be, and they are placed somewhere else. This is because of impulse, because of circumstances, and because of wrong turn. A person could have been a good artist, is sitting as a typist in an office. A person that could have been a great sportsman is a politician. And a person who could have been a politician is a farmer. Do we always sometimes think when we go to work that, oh, am I in the right job? Am I doing the right thing? So through this verse, what it's saying that in modern world, we think that we are misplaced. Everybody is misplaced. This is the reason for all mismanagement in the society. Very few people can put their hands on their heart and say that they are doing exactly what they want to do in their life. And that is what they are born for. How many of us in this room can say that today? Put their hand across their heart and say, I know what I'm doing. I'm not misplaced. Okay. They do not have themselves about the purpose for which they were born. They do not know what their strengths are, and even if they know what their strengths are, then they are not in the right fields where they can use them. Rather, they are in completely different field. Therefore, Sri Krishna is reminding Arjun what his interest is and telling him not to go against what he is inside. Rabindranath Tagore. We all have heard of him, Rabindranath Tagore. He's a well-known poet and a Nobel Prize winner for literature. He was the first Indian to win a Nobel Prize. Rabindranath Tagore, his family was a big joint family, about 100 people in Bengal. All the young boys in the family used to study and go to school. There was a family tradition that every young boy in the family would have a diary. When the boy's birthday would come, then all the members of the family would write their opinion of the boy in their diary. All Rabindranath's brothers and cousins were all very clever. One would come first in the university, one would win a medal, one would win a prize, and all the elders would praise all of them in their diaries on their birthdays. They would say that these boys would bring fame, name to the family and would make them proud. When Rabindranath's birthday would come, people would make criticism of him, like, he will ruin our family name, he does not study, he does not do anything. Rabindranath Tagore had a habit of leaving for school and not eventually going. He would end up in the garden somewhere watching kites, drawing pictures, writing poems, etc. He writes, and that is what he was fond of, and he grew in that field. He found out that what direction he wanted to go in life and started off going in that direction. Now it is said that everywhere that if the Tagore family is well known, it is because of Rabindranath Tagore. That is what he was known for writing, and he followed his heart. Nobody knows where his brothers and cousins are, who came first in the universities and got lots of medals, but nobody knows where they ended up in life. One should understand the strengths inside them. This is what Swadharma is. One should know their potentiality and about why they were born. We should find out what strengths God has given us until we go in that direction, and we will experience satisfaction in life, otherwise we will never do so. Why will Arjun incur sin if he does not follow the Swadharma? Because Sri Krishna has given him the strength to do so. He is misusing it. He will not be using it for the purpose that he is there in the world. This is sin. People often ask how it would be sin if someone like Arjun wants peace and leaves the war. From social perspective, it is because he would be not doing his duty as a Kshatriya. That is sin. But also from an individual perspective, it is because he will not be using the strength inside him. You have a social duty towards others, and you also have a personal duty towards yourself. The spiritual development that was meant to happen will stop. And this is sin. And with that, we move to verse 35.